acting G. Mac Person, I replied. So when Hansworth gave his introduction to G. Mac Person, then G. Mac Person also gave his introduction to Hansworth. What did G. Mac Person say to Hansworth? Captain G. Mac Person, I replied. I am Captain G. Mac Person of the British soldier of the British Army, and a happy Christmas to you too. So, Jim wished Hansworth a happy Christmas. I am a school teacher from Dorset in the west of England. So, before coming to the war of First World War, which was held between Germany and Britain, Jim MacPherson was a school teacher from Dorset in the west of England. Ah, Dorset, he smiled. Who said Dorset and smiled? Hansworth. I know this place. I know very well. So what did he tell to G. MacPherson? That he knew this place very well. We shared my rum ration and his excess sausage. So they shared, Jim gave his rum ration and the German officer Hansworth, he gave his sausage. Sausage is a German food. And we talk. They talk to each other. Connie, how we talked. Now he is telling his wife. Connie, how we talked. He spoke almost perfect English. Hansel spoke perfect English. His speaking in English was very good. But it turned out that he had never set foot in Dorset. He had never came to England and never been to England, neither in Dorset nor in England. So, Jim was very shocked. How could he speak such a good English? He had all he knew of England from school and from reading books in English. So Hansworth had learned all this from his school. When he was a child, he had learned all about England and English language from his school and reading different books. His favorite writer was, who was the favorite writer of Hansworth? Thomas Hardy. And his favorite book was Far From the Madding Crowd. So out there in no man's land, we talked at Bathsheba and Gabriel Oak and the Sergeant Troy and Dorset. So they both were standing in the border of the ground in no man's land and they talked about different things there. He had a wife and one son. So Hansworth had a wife and one son born just 6 months ago and his son was born only 6 months back. As I looked about me, there were huddles of khaki and grey everywhere. That means the soldiers were everywhere. All over no man's land in the border of the ground. They were smoking, laughing, talking, drinking and eating. All were enjoying the Christmas day. Hansworth shared what was left of your wonderful Christmas call, Connie. He thought the marzipan was the best he had ever tasted. So, marzipan is a sweet covering on a cake made from sugar, eggs and almonds. So, this marzipan, Jim MacPherson's wife, Connie, she has sent to him and he thinks that this is the best thing. I agreed. We agreed about everything. And he was my enemy. So, Hansworth was Jim's enemy, but they agreed over everything. There never was a Christmas party like it, Connie. So, never he had enjoyed a Christmas party like this before. So, Hansel shared his sausage to Jim MacPherson and Jim MacPherson shared his marzipan to Hansworth, and Hansel thought that it is the best thing he had ever tasted. So let's come to the next para. Then someone came and I don't know who. Jim didn't know who was he. Brought out football. So now there was going to be a football match. Great coats were dumped. So they took out their coats and they put it one on another so that they could make it pile to make their goalpost. And next thing we knew, it was Tommy against Fritz. That means Tommy means Britain and Fritz means German. So there was going to be a football match between Britain and Germany out in the middle of no man's land. That means in the border of the ground. Hans Wolf and I looked on and cheered. We enjoyed clapping our hands and stamping our feet to keep out the cold as much as anything. So you know, it was a very chilling winter December month of 25th. So they were enjoying, they were clapping and they were stamping their feet on the ground to avoid cold. There was a moment when I noticed a breeze mingling in the air between us. So you know, children, during winter when we take our breath, air comes out of our mouth, and this was happening to Hans Wolf and Jim McPherson, and even there was an exchange of air between them. He saw it and smiled. Even Hans Wolf saw it and he smiled. Jim McPherson, he said. So what did Hans Wolf said? He said, Jim McPherson, after a while, I think this is how we should resolve this war. And he suggested in this way, in this friendly way, they should resolve their war. They should end their war. A football match. No one dies in football match. So how should they resolve their war? By playing a football match. Why? Because no children will become orphaned in this football match. No wives will become widows. We know, children, that whenever any war takes place, hundreds of soldiers dies and the family loses their son. The wife becomes widow. So Hans Wolf is suggesting that to have a war, football match is the best between any country, because it will not make any children orphanage and no wives will become widows. I would prefer cricket, I told him. So Jim told that I would prefer to play cricket. Then we, Tommy, could be sure of winning, probably. So Jim McPherson is suggesting that if there will be a cricket match, then the Tommies, the Britishers, could win it. We laughed and together we watched the game. They laughed, they enjoyed, and together they saw the game. Sad to say. What is sad to say? Connie. So he is explaining his wife Connie. Fritz won. So the German soldiers won the football match. Why? Because they made two goals and the Britishers won. But as Hans Wolf generously said, our goal was wider than theirs. So it wasn't quite fair. So Hans Wolf thinks that their goal was wider than the British soldiers, and that is why he thinks that the game wasn't fair. The time came, and all too soon, when the game was finished, now the time came. The Germans won against the Britishers the football match, and the game was finished. The snaps and the rum and the sausage had long since run out. Everything was over, and we knew it was all over. I wished Hans well and told him I hoped he would see his family again soon. So he wished Hans that he would see his family again soon, that the fighting would end and we could all go home. So they thought that the fighting should end, the war should come to an end, and they should go back to their family and meet them. I think that is what every soldier wants on both sides. So what did Hans Wolf said? No soldier wants to have war. They only want peace. They want to go back home safe. Take care, Jim McPherson. So Hans Wolf said to Jim McPherson, take care. Never forget this moment of cherries, this moment of joy, of the Christmas party we enjoyed together. And I think even you will also not forget. He saluted and walked away from me slowly, unwillingly. So Hans Wolf saluted to Jim McPherson and walked away very slowly, unwillingly. He was not wanting to go. He was wanting to talk more to Jim McPherson, but Hans Wolf had to go. I failed. Even Jim MacPherson failed this. He turned to wave just once and then became one of the hundreds of grey-coated men drifting back towards their trenches. So once Jim MacPherson turned back to wave to Jim MacPherson, and even with him, the grey-coated soldiers of Germany, hundreds of them were moving towards their trenches, and everybody was wearing the same kind of dress, that is the grey color long coats. So Hans Wulff was mixed with them, and Jim MacPherson couldn't identify which one was he amongst them that night back in our dugouts. So what is dugouts? It is a shelter for soldiers made by digging a hole in the ground and covering it. So they make a hole in the ground and they cover it and they stay inside it. We heard them singing a carol. So carol is a type of folk song which is sung during Christmas and singing it quite beautifully. So the Germans were singing these carols very beautifully. It was still last silent night. Our boys gave them a rousing chorus of while Schaeffer waltzed. So the English soldiers also started singing with the German soldiers. We exchanged carols for a while and then we all fell silent. So they sang the Christmas song together and finally everybody fell silent. We had our time of peace and goodwill. They enjoyed their time of peace and goodwill. A time I will treasure as long as I live. So this is the time which Jim MacPherson will never forget. He will always cherish this moment because this was very special kind of Christmas celebration. Dearest Connie, so the letter is still continued. He is writing everything to his wife Connie. So dearest Connie, by Christmas time next year, war will be nothing. That means during next Christmas, this war will come to an end. There will be nothing left but a distant and terrible memory. That means only memory will be left and everything, every war will get over. I know from all that happened today how much the armies long for peace. So in whatever manner the Christmas party have been enjoyed by the soldiers of both Germans and Britons. They just long for peace. The army and the soldiers never want for war. We shall be together again soon. I am sure of it. Your loving Jim. So he ends his letter that he writes at the end that no soldiers wants war. And he hopes to be very soon together with Colleen, his wife, your loving Jim. So children, hope you have understood this chapter. Please go through it once more at home. In the next video, we will continue with this comprehension check. Thank you and have a good day.